Cool air in the hot summer is the best, but does it make me sicker? Hey everyone, thanks for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. American inventor Willis Carrier invented the first AC unit in 1902, and it was first put into a theater in 1925 and homes by 1965 after it had spread through commercial and retail spaces. Ancient Roman philosopher Seneca disparaged the skinny youths who ate snow to keep cool rather than bearing the heat like a real Roman. Basically, what I'm trying to say is cooling's around now, but it's been contentious forever, and it's not getting any better. People have long felt the pull of fresh air over indoor air, and there are some studies that support that idea. The World Health Organization uses the term sick building syndrome when people breathe air in a specific building and all experience similar acute health effects. A 2004 French study found of 920 women, those who worked in air-conditioned buildings were twice as likely to take a sick day or visit an ear, nose, and throat doctor. Plus, studies have shown cold air weakens the immune system against viruses in mice, showing that cold air might affect humans in that way too. The thing is, AC units cool the air and filter it at the same time. Fresh air ain't filtered, it's au naturel. So though the AC might be cooling the air, it's making it better, maybe? A good air conditioning unit is built around a system of coils containing chemical refrigerants which absorb heat from the air. The refrigerant can vary, but it's usually some configuration of chlorofluorocarbon. Inside the coils, it's a closed system of that liquid refrigerant. When the unit is on, the coils absorb heat from the outdoor air, passing it into a liquid chlorofluorocarbon, which then turns into a gas. That CFC gas is compressed into smaller coils, then forcing it to release that absorbed heat and return to a liquid state. It does this over and over and over again. That heat is then blown outside, and the cool air is blown inside and through a HEPA filter to clean the air a bit. While none of that sounds particularly evil and doesn't really seem like it would make you sick, for some reason, people are still wary of indoor air. In fact, someone once said, "No pleasure, no rapture, no exquisite sin greater than central air." But there's no actually direct link between air conditioning and SBS or any sickness at all, just a correlation. Scientists at the University of Cardiff say what's more likely is AC units dry the air as they cool, which might dry mucous membranes in the ear, nose, and throat, which allows viruses to gain a foothold. That explains the women who were going to the doctor twice as often. Of course, sickness aside, there are quantifiable problems with air conditioning. AC consumes 5% of all US electricity during the summer. That's 2 tons of CO2 per house per year. As the world gets richer and more AC units are sold, that's going to require more and more power, and that pollutes even more. In the US, around 90% of households have air conditioning, but in Africa, South Asia, and Central America, AC is still pretty rare. Though in China, 64 million AC units were sold in 2013 alone. For me, growing up in Michigan, where the highs can reach the mid-80s and high humidity in the summer, we didn't even have AC until I was in middle school. But I have to say, what is up with restaurants making it 55 inside when it's 85 outside? That is the worst. I mean, air conditioning is great, but come on. Yes, I realize this is a first world problem, for sure, but this is part of the energy usage issue. The US Department of Energy says that your energy bill increases 1-3% for every 1 degree Fahrenheit change, which means for every degree change, we're putting more greenhouse gas out. Plus, the warmer your house is, the less heat you lose to the surrounding environment, and the less your AC unit has to work in the summer. 65 degrees is the optimal temperature for sleeping, to keep your home appliances humming perfectly, and anything below 70 helps you lose weight naturally. So don't turn it down too cold, but don't keep it too hot either. How do you feel about AC? Do you hate it when restaurants are cold too? Because I really hate it. Let me know in the comments. And if you want science to ruin your summer for you even more, check out our summer fun playlist. Pools are like a bacteria minestrone. Mosquitoes, they're never gonna go extinct, and your hair might grow faster in the summer, and you can also learn how to barbecue better.
The browning of meat is called the Maillard reaction. It's named for an early 20th century chemist named Louis-Camille Maillard, and it may seem simple and tasty, but it's actually pretty complicated. Chemical changes are forever altering that piece of meat.
Thanks for watching DNews. Please subscribe so you get more videos. I'm Trace, see you later.